Good evening, and welcome to Molloy Performing Arts Club's production of Catch Me If You Can. We apologize for the delay in starting the show. Please be aware that for visual and sound effects, we will be shooting blank shots from stage guns that replicate a real gunshot sound. We ask that no flash photography be used throughout the performance, as it could be dangerous to the performers. Please turn off or silence all cell phones and pagers as it may be distracting to other audience members and the actors performing. In case of an emergency, there are emergency exits on both sides of the theater. Thank you for coming. Sit back, get jet set, and enjoy Catch Me If You Can.
This is the last call for the 12 o'clock British Airways flight VA412 to Amsterdam. Would passengers for this flight please proceed without delay to gate 17.
There he is! Stop or I'll shoot!
Hey, stop right there! Hey!
Don't move! I will shoot! I'm gonna shoot! That was close! You could hurt someone.
Come on, Frank, I'd rather take you alive than dead.
Can I at least make a statement first?
At the airport, no.
Well, I think these people want to know why you're shooting at me. I think they should know who I am, what I did and why I did it.
This is one of your tricks. You're not gonna fool me again like you did in that hotel room in LA. You're not putting on a show for these people.
A show? A show? We need lights.
What the hell is it doing?
We need cameras. This direction, this technique, a studio audience.
Red Cock, get everyone out of here.
And the Frank Abagnale Junior Orchestra.
Frank, what the hell is going on here?
My name is Frank William Abagnale Junior, and this is my story.
Where the hell did this audience come from?
I was a millionaire before the age of 21, and I stole every nickel of it. Flew 5 million miles as a Pan Am pilot, practiced medicine at a top Atlanta hospital, served as a prosecutor for the state of Louisiana, all under assumed names. Mr. Hanratty here thinks he knows all the facts, but only I know how I did it. And I did it in style.
Life, I'm living color. Let me take you for a ride. Yes, I'm live and living color. So sit back and let me be your TV guy.
So you think your life is a TV special?
No, modesty has never been one of my virtues.
Virtue has never been one of your virtues. That's right.
I'd like to tell what
right.
But I'm gonna need help to tell it well. I got a story about fame and money. And scaffold curves than a playboy bunny. I wanna live, not just survive. I wanna tell my story live and live in color. Yes, I'm live, living color. My fame lived in black and white.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Abagnale Jr., singers and dancers.
Hey, help! Folks, listen. By the time this guy was 20 years old, he'd already stolen $1.4 million. He's a con man, plain and simple. Has been since the age of 16 when he built 20 grand from his father's mobile car to buy presents for girls. When he got caught, his only excuse was,
I like girls.
Tell the folks at home, Frank, how I Like Girls became unwanted on 6 continents.
You mean the story of how Superman became Superman?
Well, your ability to go mentally and virtually in the present.
Thank you.
Live and living color, and it's brought to you by me. Yes, I'm live and living color. This won't fit on your TV.
Also featuring my parents, Frank and Paula Abagnale. My parents met in a small town in France called Montrachard after the war. My dad was a GI. My mother was young and beautiful.
All the people in that little French village were so excited to see Americans, so they decided to put on a show for us. So they crammed over 200 GIs into a tiny social room. The first woman walking out on stage is your mother. She begins to dance. The men are literally holding their breath. I turn to my buddy and I say,
I am not leaving France without that woman.
I always get into trouble when I dance with you.
When I was young, I could watch those two dance all night long.
Frank, give it a rest. I already interviewed both of your parents. Don't try to sell me.
Also featuring Playboy's Playmate of the Year, Cheryl Ann something.
I'm surprised you remember my first name.
Okay.
You know who I'm supposed
to be. Thank you, Cheryl Ann.
All right, Frank, I know the facts, and I'm taking you in.
All right, Mr. Handmaddy, I'll make you a deal. If you let me tell my story, I'll tell you anything you want, even how I passed the bar exam in New Orleans. I think we owe each other that much, don't you think?
All right, Frank, got yourself a deal.
Oh, you're gonna love this, Carl.
Yeah, I'll be the judge of that, Frank. Whatever you're calling yourself these days. Frank Taylor. Frank Williams.
Whoa! Frank Black! Frank! Put me down! I'll shoot! I'll...
What's a name? Window dressing. Everybody knows that it's the clothes that make a man. Play the game. Keep on guessing. Mix and match me. Try to catch me if you can. And I got a story to stay but true. Scoop follow me for a bird's eye view.
The family everyone wanted to be. Ladies and gentlemen, the Abagnale home.
He struggled to kick so hard that eventually he turned that cream into butter
and he climbed out.
Who are we?
We're the second mouse.
Yeah, straight, we're the second mouse. We're gonna be fine. In fact, we're gonna go downtown right now and get you your Christmas gift. A brand new Botany 500 suit.
Oh no, Dad, come on, that's way too expensive.
Frankie, do you know why the Yankees win all the time? It's not the Mick. It's not Joe Pepitone. It's the uniform. Now the other teams just stand there, stare at the pinstripes, mesmerized. Deadly scared the Red Sox so much they had to leave town.
When your mother walked into that dance hall in Montechart, what did she see? The haze and champagne, did she notice my brain or my college degree? Kid, what she saw was the uniform through the dirt and debris. Yes, those ladies gave thanks to us visiting Yanks. Pinstripes are all they see.
Ladies and gentlemen, the smartest man I know, the guy with all the moves, my father, Frank Avagnell Sr.
When a pilot walks onto the plane, all the passengers smile and relax. They know he's still tight from that party last night or the back-to-back jacks. Know what they see is the uniform. How it fits to a team. Like the visiting team that the Yankees will bring. The pinstripes are all that they and son, you'll stroll in the front door. A kid in a man's candy store. Yeah.
Everyone loved my father. Jack Barnes, the head of Chamber of Commerce, called him the most popular businessman in New Rochelle.
Why are you wearing your old school blazer? You're going to public school now.
Oh, this thing, it's only temporary. Dad'll get back on his feet in no time. I'll be back in school.
I pray that you're a soldier. You aren't afraid of anything.
Well, you do what you have to do.
Well, you do look handsome. Come to a ball.
Excuse me. Is this room 17 French?
Who wants to know? The FBI?
Yeah,
he looks like a substitute teacher or something.
Shouldn't you boys be in class? Dépêchez-vous! Vite! Vite! Vite!
Mr. and Mrs. Avignell, I regret to inform you that your son has been teaching Miss Glacier's French class.
He what?
Your son has been pretending to be a substitute teacher. Lecturing the class, giving out homework. He had 3 parent-teacher conferences yesterday. And was planning a field trip to the French fry factory in Trenton.
You'll have to forgive him. There's been so much change.
Principal, we're on our way into the office. I found this necklace on the floor. Does it belong to you?
Frank, please.
It just looks like it was made for you.
Oh, well, Mr. Avignell. Always watching.
French fry factory?
Thank you.
note from my mother excusing me from sixth period.
You should probably fold it first. It's more believable that way.
No, this really is a note from my mother.
It's the first thing you do when your mother writes you a note. You fold it up and you put it in your pocket. Dad, I met this girl today.
Frankie! You remember your father's friend, Jack Barnes?
Frank. Good to see you. Paul, take care.
Are you hungry, Frankie? I'd make you a sandwich. Frankie, you're not going to tell him.
No.
That's right. There's nothing to tell. I'm going out for a few hours with some old friends from the tennis club, and when I get back, we'll all have dinner together, right? Do you need some money, Frankie? A few dollars to buy some comic books? Here, take two.
200 soldiers in that tiny social hall. And you...
I was 16 years old when I met your father. I was your age. How could I have known what I wanted?
You wanted him.
I did. Once. I wanted to get out of France. I wanted to have a child. It was a long time ago, Frankie. Believe me. One day you'll wake up and you won't be who you were.
Someone else's skin.
$5, one way is free, and you have two.
Okay, so I didn't really know what I was doing. All I knew was I needed to get out, and my instincts took over. Maintain eye contact, keep talking, and I take my money back from the ticket seller, and just like that, I make it disappear. Then I spin some tale about meeting my grandma in the city while asking for my change, even though he doesn't owe me any change.
Wait, what?
But in his confusion, he gives me back $2, which equals $4, which is just enough for my one-way trip ticket to Manhattan, because I don't plan on coming back. Thank you, Mr. Morton.
Wait.
What?
Your ticket.
Thank you. They wanted me to choose, so I chose the New Haven line, straight to New York City. I'm gonna run from the home team and never touch down. I'm gonna run from the choices that I don't wanna make. School's not out, but I can't wait. It's the perfect time to graduate today.
And so anyway, to make a long story short, we're having turkey for dinner after all. I was just trying to expand your taste buds, she tells me. They don't need no expanding, I tell her. Normal people don't eat goose.
FBI.
The Lower Depths.
This is Special Agent Carl Hanratty. Merry Christmas.
It's all that Julia Child's fault. What was wrong with American food? Nothing till she came along. We used to be able to crack open some tuna, chop up some onion, a little celery, throw in some mayonnaise, and voila. Hot cuisine. I hate both television.
Me too. All they do is talk.
Oh, I'm sorry, Agent Dolly. Did I ask you? Did Agent Brandon ask you? Did anyone in this building ask you?
No, sir. Leave the poor kid alone. I was just having some fun with the man, Ratty. We always give the rookies a hard time. Don't you remember how they razzed you?
Yes, and it's an experience I see no reason to repeat. Now, we've got at least 3 or 4 major paper hangers working the region. We're gonna sort this thing out, even if it means we drop dead at our desk and our fossilized bones are discovered under some archaeological dig in the 21st century.
Come on, Hanratty, it's 4:45, it's Christmas Eve.
Look, we do the job because it's the job. And as long as I'm second assistant, special agent in charge of bank fraud and forgery subdivision, thank you very much. We damn well do the job until it's done. Christmas or no Christmas.
Yeah, it's easy for you to say, Hanratty. Some of us still have wives.
By the way, go home for lunch one of these days, unannounced, and see how well that works out for you. Look, I know there's some days this job lacks a certain excitement quotient.
It means every day, kid.
Days you can't get out from behind your desk, there's so much paperwork. Weeks without a leading case, months of dead ends, years of coming up empty-handed. Time will seem to stop. Nobody knows you're down here. Except him. He knows the one you're after. The day you catch him, and you will, the day you finally slap those cuffs on him is... Oh, now this is interesting. This is very, very interesting.
I know you think so, and that's the sad thing.
Look, he's changing the Micker numbers on the bottom of the check.
Micker?
Like Micker Mouse.
Who the hell is Micker Mouse?
Micker, M-I-C-R, Magnetic Ink Charter Recognition. Jiminy Christmas, Frank Taylor must have got his hands on a Micker encoder. And so did William Franklin. Look here. If you change the 20 to a 10, a check that was cashed in New York gets rerouted all the way to San Francisco. And it's weeks before the banks that cash know it's bad.
You mean those numbers on the bottom of the check actually mean something?
They mean that Frank Taylor and William Franklin are the same person. Which means you can stay in one bad place and cash these checks for weeks at a time. Must be thousands of these out there. More bum checks than a Prague prison. Brendan, send a field bulletin to the tri-state area. And you, Mr. Whatever Your Name Is, I'm on to you like a hobo on a ham sandwich.
Excuse me, I've been training as a pilot, and I was wondering, is Pan Am hiring?
aren't you sweet? Here. Here you go. Talk to Jerry Taylor, VP of Personnel. Talk to Cindy Sunday.
Oh, thank you, Miss Cindy. Oh, one more thing, is flying everything it's cracked up to be?
The only thing better than flying is a good, long layover.
Cindy, Mindy, Lindy, Kelly, Shelly, Nelly, Sherry, Terry, Kerry, and Jane, who I like to call the Jet Sets.
Woke up in Brooklyn with a frown upon my face. Just left Wisconsin, where there's cheese enough to start this rat race. But thanks to the brothers, right, we don't know where we'll sleep tonight. Yeah, I'm a bird in the skies, and tomorrow when I rise, I'll wake up in Paris with a new love in my heart.
Black from Monroe High School. I'd like to know everything there is about being a Pan Am pilot. For example, what does it mean when one says to the other, I've been on the same equipment all week, jumping puddles for the week and weary?
Means I've been flying the same plane all week. Short flights, mostly commuters.
You know what? What about those pilot badges I've seen everyone wearing?
Airline personnel badge. All pilots have to have it at all times. Like this one here from Pan Am.
Oh, I see. Well, hey, do you think I can get a picture of you?
Sure.
Okay. One second. I got it. Thanks so much.
Wouldn't you like new music and mystery? Each and every day, who's the same old music and mystery? Make a new friend and fly away and wake up in Texas where they treat their women right. And then try Hollywood where the stars get lit out in broad daylight.
Well, you see, I'm sort of just a co-pilot.
Why so nervous?
Well, how would you feel if you lost your uniform the first week on the job?
I understand. That'll be $43.97.
Oh, well, can I write you a check?
No checks, no cash. I just need your employee ID number.
Okay. That'll be 7-6-8-3-2-7.
All right, now bill Pan Am, I'll take it out of your next paycheck.
Great. You know what? That's why Pan Am will always be around.
Would you like a sleigh ride, a hayride? Kiddo, just stay home. But if you want Jet Set, then Jet Set. You leave behind hands, you serve some place like home. Wake up in Rio, have your coffee in Brazil.
Next stop is a love. Thanks. Oh, hey, do I know you from somewhere?
Maybe. I was on the cover of 17 a few years ago.
That's right. Oh, you're that model. Charlene something. In the plaza. Well, hey, could I get an autograph?
Do you have a pen? In your room.
Yeah, I think I do, actually.
So, Captain.
Oh, please call me Frank.
Frank, are you going to make me an offer?
Oh, I'm sorry, Cheryl. An offer for what, exactly?
A man like you could buy anything he wants. So what's a night worth? With me?
Well, you know, I'm really not sure, Cheryl. I'm really... 300? 500?
$1,000. $1,000.
Well, I'd have to write you a check.
You think this hotel's gonna cash a $1,000 check at 3 a.m.?
Of course. They've done it for me before. I mean, look here. It's a cashier's check.
Endorse it over to me.
That's for $1,400.
You give me the check, and I give you $400.
Even better.
Hey, Roddy, why the hell did you drag us all the way out here to Quantico? This guy's a paper hanger, he's a pen and ink man, he probably doesn't even carry a gun.
I'm getting close to this guy, I can feel it. You need to get back some of those skills you lost, wasting away at your desk. Sneaking peppermint schnapps into your coffee cup.
But we can't fix a location. One day he's in Dallas, the next he's in Rome, Stuttgart, Barcelona.
He's gone global. The last bad check came in from Liechtenstein. The hell is Liechtenstein?
The Principality of Liechtenstein is a landlocked country, bordered by Austria to the west and the south, and Switzerland to the east.
He's just a forger, Hanratty. Besides, there's no way the Bureau's gonna grant us travel money to Liechtenstein.
Liechtenstein.
Yeah.
This guy's just a forger, like Mickey Mantle is just a hitter.
Take that back.
He's got my interest peaked. That's peaked with a Q.
But you spell peaked with a Q?
It hasn't peaked in a very long time. And that's peaked with a K.
E-A-Q-E-D.
He's not just playing the game, boys. Making the rules. He is a true talent.
Jesus, Hanratty, do you want to catch him or do you want to hire him?
Look, I see this guy in my sleep. 60-ish, salt and pepper, tall. He's old school, a virtuoso. He's been honing his craft for years, but they always make a mistake. Maybe it's the overconfidence, or the wine, or the women.
What the hell?
You know, if shooting people is anything like target practice, it's very disappointing. I didn't feel a thing.
Doggone it, this job is not just about shooting people. It's not about punching the clock or waiting for retirement or
enjoying a quickie with the secretary on three. It's about this one guy, this Frank Taylor. He's out there. Toying with me. Taunting me.
Come on, Hanratty. He doesn't even know you exist.
Oh, he will. Believe me, he will!
All right, Hanratty. Keep it easy. Keep it cool.
I will not keep it cool.
Yeah, okay.
I have never been cool, and I do not intend to start now.
Jesus, Hanratty, were you always like this?
As long as I can remember, other kids wanted to play cops and robbers. I only wanted to play cops. It starts very early. Once the baby toys are gone, a kid on the playground has to choose what side he's on. It's the bullies or the good guys. Boy, there ain't no middle ground. The hoodlums try to blur the lines and twist the truth around. Though they call themselves a winner, they're just self-deceiving fools. 'Cause the game ain't worth winning if you're breaking all the rules. The law is laid upon us, but as kids we first ask why. Our parents set the rules when, 'cause I said so, they reply. And though I thought I hated them and screamed with a
problem on Mike. The next time that I had a choice, she wished I did what's right. And I never snuck a drink, I never stole a pack of coons. Cause the game ain't worth winning if you're breaking all the rules. Don't break the rules, or else we're living in the wild, wild west. Don't break the rules, God's keeping score, and you don't wanna fail that test. Don't break the rules, you thumb your nose right at the light for which I strive. But those rules, those laws keep us alive. It started back with Moses when he led around the Jews.
The Jews!
Way up that mountain, you'll pick up God's daily news.
Well, the news,
he slept on a Mount Sinai, cried and begged on their behalf.
Oh Lord,
he almost dropped those tablets when he saw that golden calf. Now we teach the Ten Commandments every Sunday in our schools. Cause the game ain't worth winning if you're breaking all the rules. I guess the Constitution, boys, is sometimes too complex. You think our founding fathers fought so they could force some checks? They see themselves as rabbit food just stealing from the rich. Not paying back if they took, well, payback is a big time. Cause the world ain't sure what forest, you can't give away those jewels. Cause the game ain't worth winning if you're breaking all the rules. Don't break the rules, or else we're living in the wild, wild west. Don't break the rules, God's keeping the score, and you don't wanna fail that test. Don't break the rules. But those laws keep us alive. If you steal somebody's money, screw his daughter or his wife, you don't think of repercussions as you tap dance through your life. Though you smile like you're a hero, you're an outlaw. Cause the odds are in my favor, man. Hey, one day I'll catch you, so go sneak into a movie. Run a red light, sell some coffee, but you're all the same to me. You're either guilty or you're not. We what we wanted every time we failed the earth.
The world will be in total chaos.
It's already on the murder spot, cause it's laws that keep us moving. Cause without them, we're just mules.
And the game would win. What the game would win? No, no, the game would win.
If you're breaking all the rules,
don't break the rules.
See you. guy to give towels to the guy who gives you towels.
You know, I heard about it in Paris. I thought it might be the perfect place to take you, when we got back to the States.
My son, the bird man. Where are you flying the plane tonight?
No, I'm actually just a co-pilot.
Where?
Los Angeles.
Hollywood! Look at us, Frankie, on top of the world, huh?
You know, Dad, I went by the store today.
I had to close the store for a while, Frank. It's all about timing. The goddamn government knows that. You know, they kick you while you're down. So I called their bluff. I wasn't going to let them take it from me. I shut the doors myself. Don't worry. Sooner or later, they'll forget all about this.
Here.
What's this?
I'll take it. You know, I can help out now. It's nothing.
It's fine, Frank. You've got your own worries.
Oh, no. Trust me. There's plenty more where this came from.
Okay, that's fine. Take good care of yourself.
Okay, but maybe if Mom sees...
Do I look like I need your help? Bird. Don't worry about your mother and me, Frankie. She's a stubborn woman, but she's a formidable woman who's has her. I won't let her go without a fight.
No. You know, maybe if she sees you open the store again,
over
and then...
200 GIs in that tiny social hall. Now, I didn't speak a word of French. 6 weeks later, she's my wife.
She could be again.
I don't know, Frankie.
You know, everything's different now, Dad. I got this great job. I make lots of money. You know, I could have breakfast in Rome, lunch in Miami, dinner in San Francisco.
Here I was thinking you were just a co-pilot. I'm proud of you, son.
Thanks.
Remember that story I learned at your feet? Now it's my turn, take a seat. Two little mice of great renown fell in some milk and proceeded to drown. The other one still the toast of the town, cause he made butter out of cream. He looked around, deduced his plight, said this is no way to spend a Saturday night. He had the style to make things right, so made butter out of cream. He kicked his legs up, he tossed and turned, so not to end up a ghost. He did a hokey pokey till the cream was churned. Later he walked out and buttered his toast. Now he's on top, for goodness sake. He's the big cheese of Battleland Lakes. It's living proof that pop, all it takes is a scheme. So if you land in the gutter, just make butter out of cream.
All right, it's your turn.
Oh, no, you do it just fine.
Oh, no, it's not a solo act. It's Frank and Dee. This is a duet.
Well, you know, there is one I haven't told you.
Oh, really?
There was a cockroach in Brazil.
No shit.
Got drunk at his local coffee mill. His time was up until he made coffee out of beans. When he came to, he heard such a sound. Much to his shock, when he looked around, he had been scooped and was about to be ground. So he made coffee out of beans. He marched to the south and he stomped to the north. He had to race against fate. In the full garage of all those different war men, senior things began to percolate. He held his breath and swam to the top. He borrowed beans from his mom and pop and opened up his own coffee shop out in Queens. When his eyes were almost coffee, just made coffee and beans.
Ready? Let's take this home, Dad.
You got it, son. So it goes to with life's the pits. A bug
and a mouse
into their wits. They do the deed. Life is that it's what you dream. So if Levin's got your singer, butter out of
I'll make butter out of cream.
I hear what you're saying, son. I'll make butter out of cream.
Always
got to get the last word in, huh?
Like father, like son.
About 3 hours ago with zero almost a week, no forwarding.
Looks like he left in a hurry.
All right, gentlemen, impress me. Man, secrets are in his trash. Mr. Taylor, real name unknown, left us a gold mine. The Flash?
He likes comic books.
He lives on junk food.
He's got a breast fetish.
God, guys, it's hand ready.
Very funny, I'll make a note to laugh later. Brenton, God, go canvass the other guests. Dollar, get license plate numbers from every car in the lot. I'll process the room. Something doesn't jive here. Flash. Peanut butter? Maybe he's got a kid. All right, Mr. Taylor, I know you're in here somewhere. Some comic books, a missed July, a matchbook from the flame, some chewing gum, a mismatched pair of shoes, a letter home that wasn't mailed, a check without a name. Yeah, they'll be my guide to the man inside the blues. Bobby pin, two baseball cards, some day-old Chinese food, two ticket stubs, the Red Sox always lose. A Valentine that wasn't sent. Set the mood when I take that ride with the man inside the blue. Pan Am stationary. As a Pan Am pilot, my family flies for free. Maybe the two of you can come out to Los Angeles with me. Maybe then. Unfinished. The two of who? Who knows? But we know he's going to Los Angeles, and so are we.
Fantastic!
It's the best idea he's had yet.
You could use the sun. If you were any more pale, you'd be transparent.
I looked into so many lives, but never had my own. The trail I've left is such a damn cliche. The lonely wife, the house for sale, a million nights alone. Wish you had the things you threw away. The front door key, a home complete, the happy bride and groom that life can bring makes you pay your dues. Then you find you're by yourself. Lonely motel room that's been occupied by the man inside.
This is the Pioneer Team.
they all clear. I was going to deposit this one today. I don't want any trouble.
There won't be any trouble. Just give me the check, and we'll be on our way.
Good, I don't want my customers harassed.
You mean you're still here?
201.
All right, I'll take the lead. Brent and Cock, get around back to all of the other exits. Put it away. If you're all good little boys, I'll buy you a good humor bar.
I thought you said there wouldn't be any trouble.
Relax, mister. You'll get one too. FBI! FBI, come out with your hands on your head!
Wow. Guy's got a Nickerman code right here. Can you believe that?
Don't move or I'll shoot!
Check this out. All these tiny little envelopes addressed to himself from Pan Am.
Put your hands on your head!
Whoa. Relax, buddy. You're late. Alan. Barry Allen, Secret Service. The guy tried to climb out that window. My guy's got him in custody downstairs.
What are you talking about?
Do you really think the FBI were the only ones on this case? Your guy's dabbling in government checks. You know, we almost had him in New York. Then again in Washington. Do you mind taking that gun out of my face? Makes me a little bit nervous.
Yeah. Let me see some identification.
Sure. I could take my whole wallet if you'd like. Would you like my gun too?
You know, I didn't expect the Secret Service on this.
Yeah, that's all right. Hey, what's your name anyway?
Hanratty. Carl Hanratty.
Would you mind if I saw some ID, Carl? You can never be too careful these days.
Sure.
Let's see. Tough luck, Carl. 5 minutes earlier, you could have landed yourself a pretty good collar.
That's all right. 10 seconds later, you would have been shot. Tell me something. What does he look like?
Well, let's see. You know, he is a pretty handsome son of a bitch.
You know, I had him figured for an older guy.
Oh, no, well, you know, he is older. He's older. I would say... Oh, I would say your age, at least.
I asked for that.
Just sit tight a minute, alright? I'm gonna get some of this evidence out of here. You know, I don't really like when people come walking through my crime scene, and the maid comes in, starts messing with all my stuff. You know, I really hate that.
Wait.
What?
Wallet.
Hang on to it. I'm gonna come back for the rest of this stuff. You know, I trust you.
You shouldn't. That was a joke. Frank Taylor.
Frank Williams? Frank Black?
Frank Fuck!
Where is he?
He had him, he was right here!
What the hell are you talking about?
He had me convinced he was someone else, Barry Allen from the Secret Service.
Barry Allen? The Flash?
What?
Barry Allen's the alter ego of the Flash.
Oh dear God.
It's okay, sir. We all make mistakes. Happens to the best of us.
Not to me, it doesn't. Not to me! Tell me this. How'd you know I wouldn't look in that wallet?
I didn't.
You're gonna get caught, you know that? One way or another. Just like Vegas, the house always wins.
You know, I wasn't so sure I'd get you in. It's Christmas. I thought maybe you had a family or something.
No. No family.
Yeah, well, me neither.
Yeah, don't you love the Yuletide fun? There's joy and cheer for everyone. I wait for Santa with a gun. Yes, Christmas is my favorite time of year.
Some sugar plums I've yet to kiss, and mistletoes I must resist, 'cause I'm on St. Carl's most wanted list.
Yes, Christmas is my favorite time of year, and there's a home by the phone. Yes, Christmas is my favorite time of year.
Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. You didn't call to apologize, did you?
What do you mean?
You got no one else to talk to.
Have to go.
Frank, wait.
Frank?
Still here. Sooner or later, you're gonna get tired of running.
Sooner or later, you're gonna get tired of chasing me.
No, I won't.
Hey, look out the window.
Why?
Just do it.
I'll call you soon, but who knows when? And Frank, I hope we'll meet again. Like when you're serving 8 to 10.
Yes, Christmas is my
everything alright, so I made this appointment and I can't.
I going to pull this one off? And then I remember, Ben Casey always made it look easy on TV.
I think what we have here is a third degree case of infection of marshmallow. Do you concur, Doctor?
I concur. What do you recommend, Dr. Casey?
Let's not rush to any conclusions. We'll run all the tests we can. We'll find out just what's ailing.
After the fake pilot's badge and the checks, well, a diploma should be nice and easy.
Very impressive, Dr. Casey. I see you brought your diploma in, too. And a recommendation from your former hospital, signed by Carl Hanrahan?
Yes, my mentor.
You're the perfect candidate.
Well, really should mention, the sight of blood makes me vomit. Oh, no, I'm serious.
All right, well, the only position available right now is over at ER supervisor, so you'd only be observing residents and interns, so you wouldn't get much real patient contact.
Oh, yeah, I'll take that.
All right, welcome aboard.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Hey, doctor, I need repair. I need intensive care. You better take heed of a Surgeon General's warning.
Brenda Strong, RN. From the moment I saw her, I knew she was the one. She was real. And it didn't hurt that she was the best nurse we had. I could use the help.
Dr. Connors, MBA, car versus bike. Should we set it or get a surgical consult?
Well, let's not jump to any conclusions, Nurse Strong. We'll run all the tests we can.
Okay, Dr. Connors, but...
But he's got a bone sticking out of his leg.
I concur. Just go.
You heard it. Go, go.
Oh, wait, not you, nurse. You 4 times a day for 11 days straight. Apparently said hello to me.
I'm so sorry, Dr. Connors. Hello.
Hi.
Goodbye.
Oh, Nurse Strong.
I'm sorry, sir. They don't like us to fraternize with the doctors.
Okay, well, pretend I'm not a doctor. Pretend. Pretend I'm a Pan Am pilot.
Oh, I don't think I could see you as a pilot.
Oh, really?
A playboy, maybe.
You know what? I'm not really into all that Riverbend madness. It's I don't know, it's kind of like a part I play.
So you're not really a skirt-chasing party animal. You just want people to think you are.
Right. Oh. Well, I meant no.
Good day, Dr. Connors.
Oh, you're very serious.
I'm just trying to do a good job, sir.
So am I. I am the youngest doctor here.
Aren't you awfully young to be a doctor?
I do get that a lot.
I'm the youngest nurse here.
I'm the best nurse we have.
No, no. No one ever listens to me. They're all so confident and sure of themselves and tall.
You know, if you want them to listen, you just have to pretend like you know what you're talking about. Act confident. Pretty soon you will be. Act brave and one day you won't be scared. Okay?
Okay.
Hey, there's a smile.
Dr. Connors! Kitchen accident. Meat slicer. We found everything but the hand.
Trauma 1! I'll call surgery! Go!
Ugh. Look at you go.
Thank you, Dr. Connors.
Oh, please, call me Frank.
Okay. Frank. Surgery.
Live and living color. Though the picture seems so clear, she's alive in a living color. So excuse me, but I disappear.
Sooner or later, they all make a mistake. Sooner or later.
While Frank was getting busy with Brenda, we were cracking this thing pretty quickly. So maybe this is my part of the show, kind of a film noir kind of thing. It was hot, even for August. So hot, my ass was sticking to the seat of the car like a fly on paper. My suit was my own personal sauna. Not as hot as the woman I was about to interview. She gave a new meaning to the word femme fatale. It's too bad she was a poor kid's mother.
I haven't seen Frankie since he ran away. I always knew I'd see this day. I can't say it's a shock. What's that expression? Kes say he's a chip off the old block. But if you see him, please pass on this plea. Don't be the stranger. Tell him that for me.
If I could just see an old family photo or a school portrait.
I don't have a recent one. Here, his junior class yearbook.
Oh, that's him! Heavens to Betsy, that's you! Glass treasurer.
Is my Frankie in some sort of trouble?
Ma'am, your son's in a great deal of trouble. He's passing bad checks, forging government documents.
So? Have the kids his age around dope, but instead you chase after Frankie because he made a little mistake? Pompey! Tell me how much. I'll write you a check.
Well, so far it's $1.4 million.
C'est ne pas possible.
Oh. It's possible. Unlikely, but possible.
Sounds like Frank is good at this.
If you're trying to raise a crook, you should be very proud.
My Frankie had a clever mind. He could spend hours all alone. I wouldn't have been surprised to find he changed his diaper on his own. Could I have been there more? Well, say the fee, but don't be the stranger. Tell him that for me.
So you haven't seen your son since you left your husband.
So I'm to blame, is that what you're saying?
I don't do blame, ma'am. Just catch the bad guys.
Frankie was the result of a night of passion in a fourth-rate hotel in Normandy. Two adults who should have known better. Nobody wins. Least of all, Frankie. Though I tried, I couldn't hide when love had flown away. Children closed their eyes, but still they see. I took a chance, a new romance. Is it a crime to say I made a choice and chose what's best?
Where might I find your son?
Ask his father. He says Frankie writes to him.
And where might his father be located?
Check the bars in town.
Okay then.
I used to be a prince to her. This prince has lost his crown. I brought her last, she brought her fur. Wonder loved him down. A wrestling clown who said the best things in life are free. Then don't be a stranger. Tell her that for me. One more round at the lost and found. That's if you've got the dough. Happy hours. Suddenly, last call.
My eyes are dry, I said goodbye. So many tears ago.
The past is just a photo
on the wall.
I guess to you I seem a schmuck. Well, I'll just buy my tie.
In love, always fair.
That lady luck can still turn on a dime.
Oh, my luck, yeah.
Maybe one will once again be three. Don't be a stranger. Tell her that for me. Christ all rolled into one. I can't live up to that.
So I did the best I could. I told him I loved him. Every day.
Maybe you should have told him, don't commit grand larceny.
Well, you know, it's the way of the world, Carl. Fathers screw us up, and turn around to the same targets. Eternal cycle.
Till someone breaks it.
Little boy, be a man. That was Pop's only plan. He never kissed me or sang baby mine. Sure, I'd have loved to hug, but hey, I came out just fine. And if I ever did cry,
bet I can guess what happened next.
He'd smack the tear from out my eye. He told me, grow up, kid, you're no Peter Pan. Little boy, be a man. You got any kids, Carl?
Can't say I do.
What the hell do you know about it, huh? I suppose your father was a prince.
Yeah,
of darkness.
Little man, grow some balls.
Oh, he did not.
Where'd you go? That motto rang throughout the halls. This. On my 10th birthday, he showed me a gun.
Yeah.
He took me to the cornfield and said, okay, run. His sense of humor was lame.
Oh, like father likes
that. That's the truth. Lucky for me, so was his aim. If he had sewn some needlepoint to hang on the walls,
he would have said,
little man, throw some balls.
All games that I missed, nights he came home pissed. Well, I don't think about that any longer.
No one in the bleachers,
fist fights with my teachers. I'm living proof, what doesn't kill ya makes you stronger.
What do you say, Frank? What do you say? We set the kid straight.
The kid's doing just fine. He served his country in Vietnam. He's doing fine.
You sure about that?
You gotta let go, Carl. You can't hang on forever. Little man, little me. They come with no warranty. Tried to fix it, who would have guessed? It's hard to say, but father doesn't always know best. So call when you have a kid.
My ex said, heaven forbid.
Do as I say, not as I did. Like dad after dad after dad after dad, the whole world began. Give you the best.
So I'll take that ride with the boy inside.
There's no need to call, 'cause home is where you are.
Doctor, we're looking for a man who goes by the names of Frank Abagnale, Frank William Abagnale, Frank Taylor, Frank Williams, William Franklin, and William Franklin Williams.
That's a lot of names.
Well, how about Robert Franklin? Frank Thompson? Frank Myers? Meyer Myers? Meyer William Myers?
Have you seen a man that looks like this?
Maybe, but that man's a pilot.
Well, he's not a pilot.
He looks like a pilot.
Well, he's not a pilot.
So he's a doctor.
Wait, he's a doctor?
Are you asking me or telling me?
Did he say he was a doctor?
Do you have any idea who you're looking for?
Frank William Abagnale Jr.
Frank Taylor, Frank Williams, Frank...
Shut up, Dollar!
Oh, we did have a Frank Connors.
Frank Collins.
Frank Connors.
Frank Connors.
Wait, so who's Frank Collins?
I don't know, you tell me.
Frank Connors! You look like this?
Oh, yeah, without the uniform. Ran off with some nurse, friend or something. Too bad, good doctor. Always turned in his paperwork.
You let this man operate on patients?
Oh no, he just supervised the ER.
Doc, you ever go in to take out an appendix and come out with something else?
Oh, once or twice, why?
Let's go. Children's Hospital.
Death Valley at the Children's Hospital?
Oh, yes, sir, right behind the Macy's.
Well, goddammit, Gumbo Brenda, I think you landed one this time. Much better than that bratty little Delacroix boy. This one is a hunky hunker, you betcha, mother.
So, Dr. Connors, you come from a large family?
Oh, please, sir, call me Frank. No, I'm an only child, but I do plan on having lots of children one day. Family is the most important thing.
Ding, ding, correct answer. But now for the make or break round. Don't lie to me now. Are you a Lutheran?
Why, yes, I am a Lutheran.
Well then, Frank, would you like to say grace? Unless, of course, you're uncomfortable.
Two little mice fell into a bucket of crayon. First one quickly gave up and drowned. The second one struggled so hard that he churned that cream into butter and he climbed right out. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen and goddamn, that was just beautiful. Where did you learn that, you pack piece of cutie pie?
First Lutheran Church of Death Valley.
So, Frank, have you decided which hospital you'll be working at when you're down here in New Orleans?
Oh, I was actually thinking about getting back into law, sir.
Are you a doctor or are you a lawyer?
Well, you see, before med school, I passed the bar exam, practiced law for a few years, and then I said, hey,
Why not try my hand at pediatrics?
You are just full of surprises.
Awfully young to be a lawyer, aren't you, Frank?
Hey, get that on.
Sakes alive, the yummy Yankee is a doctor and a lawyer, friend, that you hit the jackpot with this one!
So, Frank, where did you say you went to law school again? Harvard, Yale, Columbia?
Oh, Berkeley.
Berkeley? That's where Daddy went!
That's fantastic.
So, Frank, tell me, was that old snake Hollingsworth still teaching there when you went through Berkeley?
Hollingsworth. Grumpy old Hollingsworth, I tell you, he was meaner than ever.
And that little dog of his, Frank. What was the name of that little old dog?
Sorry to say the dog was dead when I got there, sir.
How unfortunate. A doctor, a lawyer, a Lutheran? Just what are you, Frank? Because it sounds to me like you're about to ask for my daughter's hand in marriage. I deserve to know.
To know what, sir?
The truth. What is a man like you doing with a girl like Brenda?
Well, Brenda is the best girl I've known, sir.
But who are you, Frank? If you want my blessing, if you want my daughter, I'd like to hear the truth from you now.
The truth? The truth is I'm not a doctor. I'm not a lawyer. I'm just a kid who's in love with your daughter.
No, I know what you are. You're romantic.
I am?
Of course you are. Men like us, we're nothing without the women we love.
Well, goddamn it, Gumbo. May I hug you?
Oh, Frank. Oh, Daddy.
Oh, Mama.
Would you look at the time?
Is it 7:30 already?
Is it time for Mitch?
Mitch? Who's Mitch?
Mitch Miller.
And the sing-along day!
Take it, Mother.
I feel a mighty quake. The South begins to shake under our family tree. The leaves begin to blow. Gone with the wind they go. All through our family tree. Hey, hey, what top that noise.
Dogwood bark. The seed begins to spark inside our family tree. A twig begins to poke from out that mighty oak to join the jamboree.
Something like gumbo for me.
And like a sly trombone.
I take the bar exam.
No, no,
right?
Frank, the other one. The other question.
Oh. I've made a lot of mistakes throughout my life, but I wouldn't change a single one of them because they led me straight to you. Brenda Strong, will you marry me?
Yes, Frank Connors, I will marry you.
Under our family tree, I'll sling a
you doing here?
Well, I came to see you. What are you wearing?
I took a job. A government job. A government job. You see how beautiful that is? Being there at their home game. You got a good lawyer?
I sort of am a lawyer now. So.
Take a look at this letter. It's from the IRS. They ate the cake. They ate the cake, and now they're coming back for the crumbs. It's beautiful. I'll make them chase me for the rest of their life. I had an FBI agent come see me.
No. Mr. Hanratty.
Yeah. The United States government champion got their number. Right, and they're running for the hills. It's beautiful. You gotta write that out.
No, I'm gonna stop. I'm settling down. I have a family. Wait. Here. I came to give you this. It's an invitation to my engagement party. I'm getting married. Dad, I'm getting married. Can you believe that? Everything's in there. The party, the invitation, the first class tickets for you and Mom.
Your mother's remarried. So my friend Jack Barnes. They have a house out on Long Island.
Why would she do that?
Don't get married, Frankie.
No. Why would she do that to us?
No. There's no us anymore, okay?
Okay, so then tell me to stop.
Why would I tell you to stop?
Because you're my father!
You can't stop! Okay, come on! You're an addict now! Right? Come on, you gotta find that out, baby! Find it! Lose it! Come on, sing with me! So it Clemens, for this sake! Don't just stand around and scream! Spike some lemonade and drink! And me. Frankie.
Walk away from Frank. You will get caught. You will go to prison.
Please, Carl, please let me stop.
You're scared because I'm getting close. I know you rented that car in Shreveport, the hotel in Lake Charles. You're scared. You're tired.
No, I met the girl of my dreams, Carl.
And does she know the truth about who you are?
She loves me for who I really am.
Kirk was about to be caught.
Goodbye, Carl.
Get all the Louisiana papers last 2 months. Look for an engagement notice, Frank Connors.
He would have changed his name by now.
And she knows him as Frank Connors. He loses the name, he loses the girl. Sooner or later, they all make a mistake.
You love me, right? I mean, you love me no matter what.
Well, of course.
was sick? Or poor, what if I had a different name?
Frank, where'd you get all that money?
Name? What's in a name, right? You know me as Frank Connors, right? Okay, well, we all have our secrets, and sometimes when I travel, I'm Frank Taylor. That's my secret.
Frank, what are you talking about? Why are you saying all this?
No, I don't want to lie to you anymore. I'm not a doctor, I'm not a lawyer. I'm not a Harvard graduate, I'm not a Berkeley graduate, I'm not even a Lutheran. I ran away from home 2 years ago when I was 16.
Frank, you're not a Lutheran?
In 2 days, you're gonna meet me at the Miami International Airport. Wait, here. Take this, okay? You need to leave the house when your parents are asleep. You need to give it to a cab driver. Tell him to drive you all through the night, okay? But you can't tell anyone.
Frank, I can't do that. I'll be too afraid.
No, Brenda, remember what I told you. Act, breathe, you won't be scared, okay?
Frank, please! Before you go, please tell me your name.
My name is Frank William Abagnale Jr.
I love you, Frank William Abagnale Jr.
I love you too. I have to go. No, no, there's no time for goodbyes.
I don't think I can do this alone.
You can. You have to.
Brenda!
Brenda!
Is he here? Where is he? Brenda, where is he?
He's gone.
Where did he go? Brenda, sweetheart. There are men after him in every state. Men who shoot to kill. You need to tell me where he is.
I can't.
Head ready! Three of the guys saw him leaving at the back.
Don't go anywhere.
Brenda Donald. You'll do the right thing.
Thank you.
someone.
Come on, Frank, I'd rather take you alive than dead.
Well, can I at least make a statement first?
At the airport? No.
Well, I think these people want to know why you're shooting at me. I think they should know who I am, what I did, and why I did it.
This is one of your tricks. You're not gonna fool me again. You're not putting on a show for these people.
A show?
Frank!
Oh, Brenda!
Brenda was your big mistake! We followed her right to you!
Frank, I'm sorry, I tried!
Brenda, it's okay, I understand.
All right, Brenda, get her out of here!
I love you!
Get everyone out of here! Frank, you're under arrest. It's time to stop. You don't get to walk out of your life as if this never happened.
My dad's waiting for me. We're gonna move back to New Rochelle. We're gonna get things back to the way they used to be.
Your dad's dead, Frank. Sorry to be the one to have to tell you. Grand Central Station, you fell down a flight of stairs.
No. No.
Police reports said you'd been drinking.
You're lying.
I don't lie.
No. That's not how this ends.
Sorry, Frank. It's time to give up.
You don't get to say that.
That's only on the
That was touching, Frank, truly. It's time to give up. You're under arrest. It's time to stop.
What if I don't know how?
You don't have a choice.
Yeah, I could run. I could run right now.
I know, but you won't.
How do you know?
Because you're tired of running. Because it won't bring your dad back.
I was just trying to get him back on his feet.
Look, Frank. You'll come with me. You'll serve your time, pay your debt to society. We'll get you out early. You'll come work at the Bureau.
The FBI?
We need your know-how. We're years behind on bank fraud and forgery. With all these new credit cards and computers coming out, it's only gonna get worse.
Wait, so you're saying you'll lock me up, let me out, and then pay me to do what you locked me up for?
Yep, that's what I said.
Can I get a badge?
Even better. You get a life.
But I don't get it. Why would you help me?
Because I am the only one who can.
Oh. Well, thanks for not giving up on me. You know what, Mr. Hanratty? You're pretty cool.
No one's ever called me cool before.
So, how do we end this thing?
Your way. Now stop your sobbing, kid, before I shoot. Your nose is running on my only suit. That's real, Frank, thank you. Would have thought I'd share this dance with you. Looks like we're stuck together, which is strange but true.
I guess you caught me, yeah, the chase is done. You must admit I gave you quite the run.
I did go, kid.
Hey, Mr. Tortoise, here's your rabbit stew. Looks like we're stuck together, which is strange but true.
Tell Mr. Ripley I believe it or not, the show is over and he's all that I got. Who'll believe that we'd be trying but not today?
That's okay.
Frank, thank you, Republic, while you're still in your prime. Ooh, they won't be seeing you for quite a long time. And once you're finished with your life of crime, we'll see what good behavior can do. And we're stuck together, which is strange but true. Alright, Frank, alright, tell me. How'd you cheat the Louisiana bar exam?
I didn't. I studied.
Oh, I hate you!
Mr. Hanratty turned out to be as good as his word.
Frank was sentenced to 15 years in prison, but was paroled after 7 for good behavior.
And then I set up my own security company, and I paid off every bad check that I'd ever passed.
Bastard never paid me back!
Okay, alrighty, thank you. Alright, get ready. You know what? Brenda went on to marry a real doctor. She lived happily ever after.
Yeah. Frank and I became good friends.
You know what? He even became the godfather of my children.
And that's a true story. What do you say, Frank? Should we take this thing home?
Well, up to you. You ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
One last time.
Hey, Mr. Lawyer, Mr. Two of the Eye, you never can predict when fortune may smile.
In fact, I think I'm gonna break with tradition.
Oh, boy. Okay.
And children,
oh, settle down.
Over, okay. Baby.
Oh.
I've gone fishing.
You're gonna take a vacation?
Yes,
what, kid? Now, you're coming with me.
If you'd had read this, you had said your way.
life grind us pay. But there are folks that I miss every day. But now a new duet has made its debut. Monkey see, monkey do.
Oh, get out of here, come on.
Hey. I'm glad to be on your team.
I hear what you say, prick. Let's make some butter out of cream.
Would you people give it up for this guy? Huh? I'm sorry?
I'm just gonna hold you guys here for a couple of minutes. Hey. As an alumni of MPAC, I've been with these guys for a very, very long time. This is the first time I've never been in their show, and they are unbelievably talented. And my opinion, the emotional roller coaster that it takes to do your final performance like they did tonight, I'm sorry if I start crying, but that adrenaline rush, what you guys did up here was exceptional, exceptional, and we're all so proud of you, so proud. Their best performance. We want to congratulate our graduating seniors who are graduating this year. So when you hear your name, can you please just come up to the stage? Front of the stage, please. Anna Delgado. Kelsey Dittmeyer. Jared Grossman. Catherine Gervasi. Chrissy Gansey. Jason Fluce. Kevin Kempke. Katie Mitchell. Samantha Novak. Manaja Townsend. And Carly Yonatwana. If all our seniors can come to the front of the stage, we should invite. We would love to have you make your final bow, your final performance for impact.